Friends, I am Pragya and welcome to our channel Ultimate Lakshya, a way of innovative learning. Today's focus will be on UPSC Prelims 2020 Current Affairs. As we all know that every year maximum questions are from current affairs. So friends, we have to prepare this dynamic and huge syllabus in a simple way and exclude those problems which usually students face while remembering. To execute this, I have come up with a new approach for studying current affairs. As you all can see on screen, different ministries and important body section is written, under which we are going to write various current affair topics that we will be gradually studying every day. For example, Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme comes under three ministries, or you can say that three ministries together have come up with this initiative. So here the question paper or the questioner, they might twist us or they might trick us, saying that only Ministry of Women and Child Development with Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has started it. But no, there is a third ministry, which is Ministry of HRD. And Ministry of HRD is the key point to remember here, because by the name itself, Beti Bachao Beti Padhao, we can relate that Ministry of Women and Child Development and Health and Family Welfare Ministry will be there. But thinking of MHRD will be the key point. Okay, or there is another type of trick that they might use us. They will tell that there are three ministries, which will include Ministry of Women and Child Development, Health and Family Welfare, and instead of MHRD, they might tell us some different ministry. So this is the key thing that we have to remember, that what I know and what they must be thinking. With this new technique, I am starting June 2019, Current Affairs. This will be the first part with its very first topic, Niti Aayog. So why are we studying Niti Aayog and what is it? So, it was in news because Prime Minister approved reconstitution of Government of India's policy think tank Niti Aayog, which was replaced by Planning Commission's top to bottom approach. Coming to the aim of Niti Aayog, what is its aim? So, the aim is to achieve sustainable goals and to enhance cooperative federalism. Now, what do we understand by cooperative federalism? It is a concept which reflects the relationship between center and state, where they both will come together and resolve the common problem with each other's cooperation. Hence the term has come cooperative federalism. Coming to the composition of Niti Aayog, there will be a chairperson who will be the Prime Minister, a governing council which will comprise of chief ministers of all state and lieutenant governor of union territories. There will be a regional council also formed only to address specific issues, and it will be for a specified tenure, which will be chaired by the chairperson of Niti Aayog or by a person who is nominated by the chairperson of Niti Aayog. Okay, it will also comprise of several experts, specialists and practitioners with relevant domain knowledge as a special invitees nominated by Prime Minister. We will now see a full-time organizational framework, which will comprise of vice chairperson, which will be appointed by Prime Minister, full-time member, part-time members having not more than two members from leading universities on a rotational basis, which means there will be only two members in the part-time member section and it will be on the rotational basis. And there will be an ex-officio members, which will have at max of four members. Those four members will be from the Union Council of Ministers and again will be nominated by Prime Minister. Coming to the CEO, CEO will also be appointed by Prime Minister for a specified tenure and will hold the rank as of the Secretary of Government of India. Coming to the next topic, which is Sustainable Development Goal Gender Index. Here it's written under important bodies. Why? Because in exam, Question is asked like who developed, published or released it. So, Sustainable Development Goal Gender Index is developed by Equal Measures 2030, which is a regional and global organization, which will include Bill Gates and Melinda Gates Foundation, African Women's Development and Communication Network, International Women's Health Coalition, and Plan International. It covers only 14 out of 17 SDGs, and the score to measure this gender index is out of 100. So, if any country getting 100, it reflects that they have achieved complete gender equality. Coming to India, India's rank in gender index was 95 out of 129 countries. Now, India's highest score, which is 79.9, was in health sector, whereas the lowest was in the partnership sector, which was only 18.3 out of 100. Now, coming to world's. So, world's global average score is 65.7 out of 100, which is a poor score. Now, coming to the population, world's population of girls and women, only 8% lives in country and receive a proper good gender equality school. Okay, I would like to make you come in the notice that no country so far has achieved 90% or above score in the gender equality. The next I'm going to show you here on the screen, you can see that there are 17 major sustainable development goals, and it will be really good that if you can memorize, because it will be really, really helpful for you all guys, I mean you all people to use these goals in your mains answer writing. Okay, now going to the next topic, which is one nation, one election. We will keep it under the constitutional section. Why? Because we all know one nation and one election. Election is done by Election Commission, which is a constitutional body. Hence, it will be under the constitutional body section. Now, why is it in news? Because Prime Minister called one nation, one election meet for all party, which is one nation for all party. Now, we are going to understand what is one nation and one election. It is basically holding simultaneous election of Lok Sabha, assemblies, panchayats and urban local bodies once in every 5 years. Okay, so now to do this or to hold this simultaneous election, there are numerous changes or the amendments we will have to do in constitution and legislations. Okay, as you can see on the screen, there are so many articles and acts that we have to amend, and then only this one nation, one election scheme can be implemented. Okay, now let's move on to the next topic, which is Common Service Center. Okay, this I have written it under Ministry of Electronic and Information Technology. We'll get to know why, because after I will explain you this Common Service Center, you will gradually understand that why it has come under Ministry of Electronic and Information Technology. So let's get start. Here, National Small Industries Corporation has signed Memorandum of Understanding with Common Service Center e-commerce services for enhancing MSMEs. Now, this common service centers are part of Digital India program for delivering various electronic services to villages in India, and it is one of the projects that is under integrated mission mode projects of National E-Governance Plan. It is because of this that it has come under the Ministry of Electronics and IT Ministry. Okay, now what happened in 2015, this common service sector 2.0 came, and it came to do what? To expand it to all the gram panchayats. Okay, so the motive was to set up at least one common service sector in each gram panchayat, and we all know that India has 2.5 lakhs of gram panchayats. Okay, now moving on to the last topic of this part one of current affairs is the Bharat 6 norms. It comes under the Ministry of Road and Transport Highways. We can figure it out. Bharat 6 norm is related to vehicles, so it will be Ministry of Road and Transport Vehicles. Okay. So why was it in news? It was in news because International Center for Automatic Technology, that is ICAT, released India's first type approval certificate for BS 6 norms for two-wheelers. Okay. In 2018, ICAT, which is International Center for Automatic Technology, approved BS 6 norms to Volvo company, and it was for the heavy commercial vehicles only, but now it has come for the two-wheelers also. Understanding BS norms, so it is an automatic emission norms which the automatic manufacturers have to comply or act in accordance with to sell their vehicles in India. Now, Government of India, it skipped BS5 norms and directly jumped to BS6 from BS4 norms. Why? Because to curb air pollution. And BS6 norm has already started from the very 1st April to 2020. Now, what is the major difference that government skipped BS5 and directly jumped to this BS6 from BS4? It was the sulfur content. So, why sulfur content? So, BS4 had 50 parts per million ppm content of sulfur, whereas BS6 has only 10 ppm. Hence, it is really helpful for reducing air pollution. Okay, I hope I was able to make you understand, and if there is any problem in understanding the way I am categorizing all the various current affair topics under the ministries, please, if you have any problem, do comment and let me know. I will make sure to make you to come up with a better way of understanding. And with this here, I am ending this part 1 video. Stay tuned to our channel for new lectures, and please subscribe our channel, click on the like button and share our videos too. Stay safe and thank you.